a brief introduction on our speaker, ma'am, today. Ms. Priyanka Arora is a psychologist, a mental health professional, RCI affiliated counselor, and a wellness coach. She is the founder director of Antarman, Making Lives Happier, which is a center for counseling. She realized that a lot of individuals need support with regards to wellness, knowing self-worth and finding their purpose in life. Her niche areas of work are loving and discovering oneself, finding one's passion, purpose, and how to live a healthy and a stress-free life. Priyanka Arora provides counseling services to school, colleges, government organizations, as well as the corporate sector. She is currently associated with renowned organizations like National Institute of Fashion and Technology, NIFT, Jodhpur, Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, Jodhpur, and Government Polytechnic College, Jodhpur. She is also rendering her services for Army welfare and conducts various wellness workshops for the society. So we welcome Ms. Priyanka Arora, ma'am, to this platform amidst us. And I now like to hand over this session so that she can carry forward with her speech. Welcome, ma'am. Kindly take over the session.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Aradhana ji, for making me a part of this faculty development program. And I hope together this journey of 1.5 hours is going to be a remarkable one. So thank you once again. Okay. Good afternoon to all the participants present here. Today, we are going to have a session on resilience. Before starting the session, I would like to ask you a few things, or even we can interact with few things, and you can use your comment box so that we can have this interactive session. And agenda of today's session is cultivating that coping strategy which is going to manage the stress in the lives. So if I ask you one thing, this COVID-19 pandemic time, I know this is the crucial time for each of us. This is a global pandemic. So we are all sailing in the same boat, but we all need to cultivate few strategies to maintain the well-being. If I ask you to define yourself in one word, I know this is not so easy to define oneself in one word. But yes, this is the activity, or this is something I use to start with my sessions so that we all get closer and knowing about each other. Great. So you all started replying to me. I'm really happy and blessed to have you all here. So please feel free to give that one word to yourself so that we all have an interactive session together. Wonderful, reserved, active, great. So I know 88 people are here, I guess. So please try to give that one word to yourself. Wonderful, passionate, active, capable, optimistic, creative, great, positive, wonderful, resilient, wow, emotional, positive, happy mind, wonderful, joyous, positive, adjustment, emotional, determined, smile. Wonderful words are coming out. Great. Happy. Okay. Lion. Irritated. Okay. It's all right to be like this also. Optimistic, enthusiastic, comfortable, wonderful. Optimistic, wonderful. Confused. Okay. Mm-hmm. Energetic. Mm-hmm. Okay. I think more people are here. Mm-hmm. Cheerful. Great. Diplomatic. Okay. Confident. Beautiful. Okay. Beautiful words you all are using for yourself. I really like the way you like yourself. Awesome. Rejoice. Okay. Great. Straightforward. A beautiful trait to be straightforward. Optimistic. Calm. Colorful. Okay. Cool. Innovative. Wonderful words are coming out. It means you people are really great that you are using such great words for yourself. Amazing. Okay. Positive. Consistent. Wonderful words. Love to smile. Face anything with cool mind. That is really important. Really. Calm. Okay. If somebody is left, please. Okay. Full of energy. Love yourself. That's the real funda of life. Love yourself. Systematic. Strong. Good. Cool. I really like this word cool, because cool mind is always a composed mind. Compromise, positive, capable, strategic. Great. Anybody who's left? You know, we all have to use the integrity quality. So if I don't know that you are left, aesthetic, overcome, positive, dynamic. Wonderful. You all are dynamic personalities. Greenish. Okay, what's that? Shrabanti Das is saying greenish. I really like the word. Straightforward. Okay. Resilient. You all, most of you all are already resilient. That's really good. Secular. Rediscover yourself. Determined. Great. So, is there anybody left? If there is somebody left, please try to give that one wonderful, beautiful word to yourself, because you are most important for yourself. Attitudes, great. Okay. You are the most beautiful creation, as well as you are the most wonderful and the most important person for that one person, and that is you. Marvelous. Okay. I'm getting beautiful words, unique, positively. Simple, okay. Glorious. Look, these beautiful words are making the beautiful ambience, the environment, the energies. Feel the energies, the word you are writing, and the amount of energy flowing in yourself, and the way you are looking to each other's words. It again optimizes the energy flow in all of you. This is really important. Before starting my session, if there is someone left, please, please, please feel free to give that one word to yourself, because I don't want that somebody is left, okay, morally pure. Wow, that's really important, to be pure morally. Okay, so if everybody is done, anybody from your side, give a thumbs up so that I know everybody is done with this activity of giving yourself that one word. I hope all of you are done. Okay, amusing, strong. Great words are coming from your side. And I hope this journey of 1.5 hour is going to be the same as this is. This comment box has to be like this only. It has to be filled with the comments from your side, so that I'm not going to feel it like I'm only speaking and you all are just listening, because this is going to be an interactive session. Thank you so much. So few of you are giving the thumbs up. It simply says all of you are done from your side. Okay, humorous. Another beautiful word is here on the screen. Humorous. Wonderful. Great. So this is the humble request from my side to all of you, is lovely. Okay, done. Believe in yourself. Still more words are coming. Mentally excellent. Great. Actually, this is important, Chitrasen, Mr. Chitrasen. Mentally excellent is really important these days. Fine. So all of you are done. So now let's start today's session with all of you wonderful people out here. So the concept here is, Okay, the few words are coming. Beautiful. Okay, fine. I think heavenly. The concept here we all are going to talk upon is resilience. So now I'm going to share the slides here, and then we will be discussing on slides. And the one more thing I would like to say, or the request from my side, is feel free to use the comment box. If you have any questions, we are going to cover all those questions in the last 10 to 15 minutes. So please, if you have any questions, write it down. And meanwhile, in between, if you have any queries regarding the slide, regarding the topic, please ask me freely. So now let's start the slide so that we can start today's session. Okay, so this is a very common, very famous, very popular phrase written here. Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you react to it. It simply says, beautifully written by Charles L. R. Swindoll. This quote simply says, our attitude matters most. As we all know, that we cannot change the inevitable. The only thing we can do is play on the one string we have. We are the in charge of our attitudes. In this unprecedented times of COVID-19 pandemic, we all need to have a right mindset and improved mental immunity. Listen, here I'm using the word mental immunity. Since long back, we are listening from everyone that we all should boost our physical immunity so that we do not get the virus easily. But here, I am talking about the mental immunity. Yes, this is that immunity which is equally important for each of us to combat the infection. And mental immunity is nothing else. Is to have a right mindset, the right coping strategies to overcome the stress or any other negative situations arising in the life. So I was talking about an improved mental immunity and also a mental hygiene. As we all take care of our physical hygiene, we have a ritual of waking up in the morning, brushing our teeth and taking a bath and all the other things. Are we taking care of our mental hygiene or the emotional hygiene? Are we taking care of our emotions? Are we taking care of thoughts? Are we taking care of all those things which are equally important to thrive instead of survive? Yes, my dear friends, that's what I'm going to ask you or tell you. Instead of surviving, we all need to grow and thrive. And that is the agenda of today's resilience session, is to make us all that important quality, that is thriving instead of just surviving. So here, today's session is going to throw some light on that skill, which is going to empower us. So why I started with this quote is simply saying that we are the in charge of our attitudes, and the session which is on resilience, we all know resilience is not a personality trait. It's not something which is innate. It is a learnable skill. It is something which we can cultivate so easily in our day-to-day life. So yes, let's move to the next slide. Okay, fine. Another activity or another question for all of you, because I always want to have the engaged audience. All of you, please give the meaning to these three words, these three alphabets. This is B, C, D. Come on. What according to, okay, Animesh Nandiji is saying, right? Okay, somebody else want to tell us? But the first audience, if you have given the answer so correctly, so I have no choice to ask others. Okay, bold, courage, discipline, great, bold, caring, daring. I'm getting many more new words before COVID days. Okay, you're talking about the before COVID days. Great. Book, cook, cafe, best can done, bold, care, decisive. Wow, you know, learning is a mutual process. And today I'm going to learn many things from you all. Before and after marriage, great, okay. Okay, so beautiful, colorful, determined, B comes before D. That's really amazing, the humorous one. Beginning, continue, destruction, great. Birth, character, death, okay. Fine. Be careful, dear. Okay, Shobhaji, it's really wonderful. Be careful, dear. Really great things. Okay. Beautiful, cherish, determine, bold, clear, discipline. Okay, bold, caring, dedication. Great. Best childhood days. Wonderful things coming from your side. Big creative dream. Okay, fine. This is my answer. As one of you had answered this very first, really, applause to you all, that you all have given wonderfully, there is nothing right or wrong. Everything is subjective. So again, I'm going to say this thing to all of you. Please feel free to use the comment box wherever you want. Feel free to use it. Yes, birth and death. The B, Animesh sir. Okay, thank you, Animesh sir, for the answer. Okay, be creative, dear. Still, I'm getting few answers from all of you. Thank you so much. Okay, birth and death. Both are not in our hand. We cannot decide birth. And even we cannot decide the death, time and place. But the course between this birth and death, the life between this birth and death, we can decide it from our choices. Yes, C plays a very, very, very important role in the course of our life, whether we are going to make it or break it. This is something very important thing we all should know. Billion choices dealt with. Okay, Amit Kumar Dasji, thank you so much for the answers. Now we are moving forward with our slides so that we can, we will be able to complete the session in the given time. So yes, I have many activities for all of you. So just let it continue. Birth, career, death. Okay, Lipika ji, thank you. Fine. So here we are talking about birth, choices and death. It simply says we cannot control birth and we cannot control death. But yes, we can control the choices. The choices we make makes our life or breaks our life. So this is something very important thing which we all should know before starting the main agenda of the session, that is resilience. So next, I would like to give one more important thing to all of you, or just to share with all of you, is this is something many of you must be knowing about, this butterfly effect. So yes, as I told you that I want to have this session to be very interactive. Please, anybody from your side, if you know about the butterfly effect, please tell me if yes or no or thumbs up, so that things will go on very smoothly. Okay, great. Okay, wonderful. Many of you are saying yes, few of you are saying no. Great, great. As you all are from engineering college, like faculties of engineering college, this is something very obvious that most of you are knowing, because this is a part of chaos theory of maths. So yes, it is chaos theory. Mm-hmm. Okay, fine. There is no big deal if few of you are not knowing about this theory, but I'm not going to elaborating this theory in detail, okay, transformation. But here I'm just going to pick that one essence of this theory for all of you, or the essence of this effect for all of you. Yes, Madhuri is Madhuri ji, you're saying right. Small things make big differences. This is something the butterfly effect says, changing one thing can change everything. Every single thing you do matters. You have been created as one of a kind. You have been created in order to make a difference. I always ask my students or my audiences, my participants in different webinars and different sessions, change should come from within. Yes, you are saying right, Mr. Joseph. I always say to my participants and my audience, why I'm using all such things or I'm sharing all such things with you, this is something coming from inside. The innate things are coming out. I always ask them to be a mad, and they give a perplexed look at me. Why mad? What does it mean, mad? So yes, now there's an activity or question for all of you. Can you please give me the meaning of this acronym MAD, M-A-D? Don't you say me mad? Are you mad, ma'am, that you are asking mad, the meaning of mad to all of us? But yes, this is an activity. I will keep you engaged, because I know many of us know many things about the things like resilience and these butterfly effects. But the only important thing is to interact with each other. Fool, crazy, pagal, okay. Different words are coming from your side, passionate. I am repeating my words, my dear friends, that I asked you, yes, meaningful action done, that give me an acronym. This is an acronym. I'm not asking the meaning of MAD. I'm asking the full form of this acronym MAD. This is very simple, yet my own creation. So I don't want you to get confused in all other things. But yes, you can use that your way, because I already told you everything is subjective. Nothing is right or wrong. Okay, want to achieve target, make a decision. Wonderful. Things are coming out beautifully. Like you people are really amazing, mental and defective. Okay, mutually assured destruction. Wonderful, wonderful. Look, my answer is there somewhere in between what I spoke right now. Why I'm keeping such things in between, so that we all keep ourselves engaged and attentive in the session, during the session. Make a difference. Yes, yes, please, please, please. Who was this? It was just in a blink of eye, your name came and popped out. Professor? Okay, okay, fine. Please make a difference. Madhuri ji is also saying make a difference. Great. Yes, this is what from my side. Make a difference. We all need to convert our dents into differences. As we all know, life is full of ups and downs. Life is a roller coaster ride. We cannot live without having any negative or unwanted emotion or a moment or a situation in our life. We all have to have all such things in our life. It's, you know, it's very normal to have negative and positive in a life. We cannot enjoy the sunshine without a night. We cannot enjoy the rainbow without the rainfall. Similarly, it says make a difference. Irrespective of any situation we all are dealing with, we all need to have that courage to convert our pain into power, to convert our dents into differences, to convert our obstacles into opportunities. And this is what this butterfly effect says, and I'm just not elaborating it. I'm just giving a piece of essence of this effect, that changing one thing can change everything. And in another word, I can say small things make difference, big differences. If you will take one single step towards a betterment, towards a positive mindset, towards something productive, towards a transformed life, definitely you are going to create difference in many lives. And then it is going to be MAD, MAD, make a difference phenomena, make a difference philosophy. Yes, we all need to cultivate that thing in all of us that says be a MAD, because everything is possible. Anything can be solved. there is nothing in this entire world, entire universe, which cannot be solved. So yes, we are going to start the main session or the main thing which we are going to have it, the resilience. Resilience. What is resilience? As you all, again, I'm going to say that you all are from the engineering field. So this is something you are going to relate it with the physics. Let's connect it with the psychology. Yes, elasticity. Very good. That's what I said. Now you all are from engineering, so you all are going to relate it with the physics. But being a psychologist, being from a psychology background, I'm going to relate it with the psychological parameters. Yes, Padmaji, very good. Back to normal. Shyamalaji is saying flexibility. Madhuriji is saying adaptive. Yes, of course, adaptive. To be adaptive is the most important quality of a person. Elasticity, be different, okay? Wonderful things are coming out. Ability to accept difficulties. Yes, of course, ability to accept difficulties. But do you realize, are we really doing all these things in this pandemic time or in this time of high uncertainty? Flexibility in situation, adjusting, okay, things we do will come back to us, okay, this is the law of karma or cause and effect relationship, okay, yes, we are adjusting, knowing one own self, accept as such, okay, fine. You all are giving beautiful, wonderful and very apt answers, very apt. But as I asked you, okay, Dr. Vijay is saying ability to bounce back. Yes, of course. Ability to bounce back is the resilience. Very simple. We all know that this is something resilience, we all know. But are we really practicing this in our life? Are we really doing the things which we actually should, the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties? No. Okay, no. Yes, of course. If you feel like this, that your answer is no, you are really free to say this. Because I always say one thing to each of my people, my audience, or everybody, that it's totally okay to say, I am not okay. It's not always important. It's not always essential to be in a very balanced state. We need to be in that balanced state, but it is not possible. We sometimes lose our sync. We sometimes create that imbalance in the homeostasis, which creates problems in our life, which hampers our physical and mental health both. So yes, it's the power of mind and concentration. Yes, wonderfully, beautifully said by all of you, that it is a power of mind, it is art of bouncing back. And at the same time, most of you are saying, no, we are not at all using this quality, this skill in our daily life. Why this is going on? Come on. Okay. We have to learn from our kids. When they fall, they stand back or they jump out. Yes, of course. But here, if you asked or if you said something about the children, are we really cultivating this quality in our children? Please tell this thing to me very honestly. Are we really cultivating this thing to our children? Yes, they have this innate ability, so they are just coming out with this. Yes, no. The answers coming out from your side is no. We are raising perfect children. We are not raising happy children. We tend to cultivate IQ in them. We want that my child has to be successful. My child has to be competitive. My child has to be, intelligent or something like that. But are we doing certain things that can cultivate the AQ in them, the adversity quotient? If you asked about the children and if you have wrote down about children, so that's the only thing I'm just giving you a very short brief on this thing. Like, we all have IQ, EQ, SQ. This is again related to resilience. That's the only reason I'm sharing it with all of you. Like, we all are raising our children in not so apt way. We are giving them IQ, we are giving them EQ, we are even making them learn SQ. I have trained myself to make my son do on his own. Okay, I'll definitely read your comments in between. But are we really making them learn the AQ? And AQ is adversity quotient. AQ is something which is very, very, very important in these crucial days or in any days. You're writing some coming of mind to our original state. Yes. Yes, of course, coming of mind to our original state is really important. Satyavirji is saying, have no idea. So we are talking about AQ. AQ is something actually related with resilience. And if we are specifically talking about our children, so we really need to create or cultivate that AQ in our children by delaying the gratification, by delaying the things which they want, and we are just giving in a moment. These days when we the parents are becoming more materialistic, more, we are not able to give them a quantity time, we are giving them quality. But actually, the AQ part is missing somewhere. So let's continue with the resilience. And this is the definition, the specific, very traditional definition of resilience is, it's our mental stamina, our inner strength to cope up with stress, uncertainty, and chaos, or ability to bounce back from negative experience within a relatively short period of time. Yes, this is something all of you must be knowing. But again, this is activity time. I'm going to give you this activity. You must be having a pen and paper with you. So do one thing. Give 5 minutes or couple of minutes, whatever time you want to take, like not more than 5 minutes. And just memorize that one moment when you bounce back and come out as a transformed personality. Write that moment and another one. Write that moment or that situation of your life, that event of your life when you failed to bounce back. And what thing happened to you? What situation arise in front of you? Two situations, one where you bounced back, the another you failed to bounce back. The first, how you come out, and the second, what happened to you if you failed to bounce back? Just two situations, and I'm just giving you a couple of minutes, or you can take 5 minutes, so that we are going to continue and it's going to be covered in the given period of time. So if you all are ready, I'm not going to ask you what you had written, or I'm not going to ask you to disclose the things, what you felt or what you realized that time. But yes, just give me a thumbs up if you had written both the events, both the situations, one where you bounce back from that situation, that negative event of your life, the another one when you failed to bounce back, how you felt. Please do this activity, do this exercise. This will really make you feel how resilient you are, or how much resiliency you need to cultivate in yourself, in your personality now. So yes, okay. Many, many, many of you have done, and I'm getting the thumbs up from your side, really. And this is something what I'm giving, these activities are the proven activities which actually make you feel like, yes, I really bounced back from that negative situation and I forget about it. And another situation, I fail to bounce back and I forget about it. But yet here, this is the time to recall those memories so that you can feel the power of you. You can feel, yes, I need to be more resilient. I need to cultivate this quality in me so that in the coming time, in the future, I will not be failing again. Because again, I'm going to say this thing, really, resilience is a learnable skill. Resilience is something which you can cultivate in your personality. It's not a trait. It's not something innate. It can be learned. So that is the best part of resilience. And I always say, one size doesn't fit all. Simply says, we are all unique. We all are different. So one way of resilience cultivating is, it might be the other person cannot be adopting the same way, or you may having some other ways to adopt or cultivate the resilience in you. So here, if you all are done with the activity and those who are yet doing, I will just wait for a couple of minutes so that all of you can do it properly. Okay, many of you are messaging me that done. And please write if you have any queries, so write it down and we'll have last 10 minutes Q&A. Okay, so if you are done, one more minute to go and then we'll continue with the next slide. And definitely this is something, the activity is going to be useful or helpful to know yourself better, because knowing yourself is the wisdom. Knowing others is mere intelligence. And we all should be having the wisdom that knowing ourselves is really very important. Very important. Okay, so let's move forward. As many of you were saying that you already know about resilience, being from the physics and engineering department, this is but obvious that you all know about the resilience. But if we talk about the resilience in the psychological, or this term where we have another four types of resilience, this is physical resilience. As somebody from your side is talking about that, if a child falls down, the child has the ability to jump up back. So that is something. If the child gets crashed, the child will not cry because he or she is having that ability to come out from that physical stretch, scratch or something like that. The social resilience is another way of being or having the ability of bouncing back if you are having some communication gap or something which is creating trouble or hampering the cordial relationship between someone, or any relationship is getting hampered. You have the ability to come out with all those parameters to get back into the cordial relationships. The third one which we are going to talk today is the mental resilience or the psychological resilience, which is very, very important. Okay, which is very, very important to empower ourselves and to prevent our mental health from getting hampered. The fourth one is spiritual resilience. Yes, of course, spiritual intelligence is of a very important thing in our life, because if we are having the spiritual quotient in our life, definitely we are going to have a phenomenal journey in course of life. So today we are going to talk on mental resilience or the psychological resilience. Hope you all are done with the activity. And if you are not done, please, please, please try to do these activities whichever I'm giving you, because somehow they are of psychological importance to all of you. So please do the activities. It may be making you feel like that you are empowered, you are a resilient person, or it may be like that you need more resilience and need to cultivate more resilience. So here are the few qualities of a resilient person. Very simple in looking, yet very difficult in adopting. these basic qualities of a resilient person. Here are the very few and the basic qualities. They have a very strong belief in their abilities. As we are talking since past 5 minutes, that if you know that you bounce back from that negative situation or event of your life, definitely you feel good about yourself. You feel strengthened about yourself. You feel like, yes, I did it. Now you are getting that feel of, I did it during that time and I can do it in my future also. So having a strong belief in your abilities is very, very, very important to be a resilient person. Okay, somebody is saying, is experiencing, learning and moving forward equal to resilience? Yes, of course. Experience itself is a very important part of life. I must say, one who is having the theoretical knowledge and another who is having the practical knowledge, I will definitely go with the person with practical knowledge, which comes with experience. And life is full of experience, and we need to have experienced, mentors, guides with us so that we can also move forward, learning and moving forward. Yes, of course, these are equal to resilience. These are part of resilience. And moving forward is definitely equal to resilience. So yes, definitely you are right, Mr. Faris Mohammed. The next one is, they don't give up easily. As we are talking on the few basic things of a personality of a person, which says giving up easily is not our cup of tea. And believing yourself is something which will keep you moving and moving. Somebody is saying, anyone recovered from a disease is a physical resilience. Look, recovering from a disease includes all kind of resilience. It also includes mental resilience as well. Because if you want to recover from a particular situation, definitely you will recover. As we are knowing about the facts, many people who are having the lifestyle diseases, there are many diseases generated from the lifestyle these days. And if they have a will and a skill to get, overcome from that particular phase of their life, definitely it is going to be recovered. So recovering from a disease itself includes all the resilience in a whole. It's a holistic approach. So this is my answer to you, Shrabanti Dasji. How to forget the pain and bounce back? I think we are going to cover the questions in last 10 minutes. Meanwhile, we are just taking it. They generally look at the brighter side of life. This is for you, Premila Swamiji. How to forget the pain and bounce back? Looking at the brighter side of life. And again, the activity for all of you. One fine day when you sit, take a pause, take a break or from all the chaos of your life and write down the blessing part of your life. If you will start counting your blessing, I am absolutely, I'm 100% sure that you are not going to, saying like that, okay, I'm not having good things in my life. If you will start writing down the blessings of your life, you will fail to count. It is going to be enormous. It is going to be uncountable. Just sit, take a pause, take a break. Just introspect yourself. Look at your life, look at your surroundings and write down. You will have enough number of blessings in your life, 100%. The next one is, they let mistakes go and focus on what next. Yes, of course, this is the most important quality to be a resilient person. If we will keep on focusing on the problems, we are not going to have more solutions of those problems. For example, if you will start from your home and you are a bit late in the morning, if you go at the crossing and you find that red light at the crossing, you find it, oh my God, this is, my fate is really bad. I'm getting red lights here. Again, if you will go to the next crossing, you will find again a red light. They don't know. that Mr. XYZ is coming and they have to put these red lights at every crossing. Just cool down. This is a very simple example of focusing on the problems instead on the solutions. Meanwhile, if you are really standing on that crossing, just enjoy the surroundings, enjoy the little things which you usually don't look at. So this is something very important for each of us to focus on the solutions instead of the problems in life. And a very beautiful thing from the neurology background is neurofilters. We all have neurofilters in our brain that tend to create that thing in our mind that we are going to expand all those things which we focus on. You all must have listened to that one phrase, what you focus on grows. Yes, of course, if you will focus on problems, definitely they are going to grow. Similarly, if you are focusing on the solutions, they are going to grow. So here I am going to tell you one thing, that focus on solutions instead of problems. Next one is, they let mistakes go and focus on what next. Yes. And the next is, they don't worry about bad luck and focus on what they can control. Yes, keeping cursing the bad luck is actually not at all working in our life. And focusing on what they can control is something which we all should apply and work to make a betterment in our life. So these are the few qualities of a resilient person. And now if you all ask, fine, these are the few qualities of a resilient person, but how to build that resilience and how to be that person so that we can have, you know, this beautiful trait in all of us. Very simplified and very easy to go points are given here. If you want to take a quick glance at these points, and I'm going to elaborate in my way, make connections. Relationships and connections are integral part of our life, and they really make us happy, they really make us fulfilled, they really keep our well-being in a very empowered way. Move towards your goal is another way. Whenever we have a goal, we have a purpose in our life, it really makes us motivated. It makes us keep on moving and going and growing. Take decisive decisions. All of us can take decisions, but decisive decisions are very important to take. Look for opportunities for self-discovery. Make a positive view of yourself. Yes, this point is very important to note down. Make a positive view of yourself. Our self-worth is really very important. Our self-worth is of a vital role. It plays a vital role in all of us. Because if you have a positive view of yourself, definitely you look at the positive side of your life, others' life, and the situations going on. Stay flexible. Yes, this is something which is the real meaning of resilience. Staying flexible. As you all know, that resilience means flexibility or the elasticity. Similarly, if we bounce, if we throw a ball on the ground, it comes up, it bounces back. So we all need to have this quality in us so that we can come out or we can overcome any stressful situation in our life. As I told earlier, theoretical knowledge and practical knowledge, I know they go hand in hand, but this very simple three-step formula is a proven formula, is a used formula, is a very simplified formula created for all of you. As we all know, many things are written here and there about resilience. We can read, we can listen, we can watch. But this is something I used in my life, I executed, and then I come out with the concept of this R, the single R, which is giving these three concepts or these three things which can develop our resilience. This is a cultivate in our life or which we all can adopt. This is something simplified as realizing the reality. Sometimes we know the reality, but we keep ourselves on the denial mode. We keep ourselves on that mode which says, no, it doesn't exist. It is not possible. But here I'm going to give you this fundamental thing for all of you is realizing the reality. Realizing the reality simply says you should be aware of the situation. You should accept that situation and should know how to adjust with that particular situation. This is the realizing the reality concept, which again is the three A's in it. The awareness of the situation, the acceptance of the situation, and the adjustment with that situation. Please don't use the denial mode every time. And sometimes if we use this concept, it simply says, knowing about what's going on in your surrounding, knowing about who you are, knowing about your strengths, knowing about your weaknesses, and knowing about the world. Actually, this is really important in this crucial time, in this time of crisis, when we all are having a very negative mindset, a very unprecedented times, full of anxiety, full of, nothing is going to clear this thing. We are not clear what is going to have in future, when this COVID-19 is going to be over. Something is all time going on and on in our mind, which is not at all right. Realize the reality, accept it, aware about it, and then try to adjust with it. The second R simply says respond instead of reacting. This is something really very important for all of us. We usually react at every situation instead of we need to respond so that the situation is not going to be permanent in our life. But if we react to that situation, maybe the results may vary. So if you really want to keep the results in a balanced way, start responding to any situation instead of reacting. Yes, of course, somebody from your side is saying repair your lenses carries a very broad world in it. Can you please just throw some light on how this repair your lens carries a very broad world in it so that I can continue with my repair your lenses? Okay. Fine, so we are going to talk on repair your lenses. Simply says we need a paradigm shift. We need a change in our perception. This is my concept of, yes, this is my concept of repair your lenses. Sometimes we always look at the negative, the not so good things in the surroundings, in the person in front of us, or in any situation. Sometimes it happens with ourselves, means we don't look at the good things in us. We always look at the negative part of ourselves. We always look at the, I'm not good, I'm not self-worthy, I'm not, I cannot do this thing, I cannot have this thing. Try to repair your lenses instead of cursing the situation, instead of cursing yourself, instead of cursing what's going on in the world. Take a paradigm shift. Get your perception changed. Definitely, the things will come out as the different one. You may have changed the perspectives and you may have looked at the things in a very different way, and the things will come out in a very different and transformative as well as the productive way. So this is very important to have all these three R's. Okay. Somebody is saying changing our mindset from negative things to positive. Yes, this is something I'm saying to have a mental shift. As we talk upon the mental hygiene, we all need to have a mental shift, a mindset which is negative from a mindset which is positive. And as we all know, we cannot be positive all the time. Life cannot be good all the time. But how we are going to deal with all situations, how we are going to realize the reality during that particular time, this R will answer all the solutions. This is realizing the reality, responding instead of reacting, and repairing your lenses. This is a very simple thing, like R for resilience, and the solutions are already there in R itself. Okay, somebody saying love oneself and have a positive judgmental mind for everyone. 100%, you are absolutely right, Dr. Suchismita Bhattacharya. It is something very important to loving yourself, because I always say, if you can love yourself, only then you can love anyone or everyone. Yes, Sanjay K. Sharma ji is saying, do not too positive. Yes, absolutely. Excessive of anything is injurious. You cannot be positive all the time. You have to be balanced in situations. You cannot be so much into that if you are positive, you can be negative. You cannot be, you don't have to change the attitude. Yes, of course. Changing the attitude always plays a very, very important role in our lives, because attitude, and we are the in charge of our attitude. So now we are going to have this quote with all of you. When the going gets tough, the tough gets going. Very simply saying, but it is of very great importance to each of us. We all know, when the situations are negative, what we are going to do is really very important. Are we going to make ourselves or break ourselves? This is really important for each of us, whether we want to survive or thrive. So yes, let's take a pledge to thrive instead of just survive or feel negative about the current situation or any negative situation of our lives. So this is something I was telling about the resilience, and the question part we can start now. We have, okay, we are on time. But yes, if you have any queries, you can. No, we have still. When the going gets tough, the tough gets going. Now, another activity for all of you, which is, please write down three situations or three events which gives you pleasure. So any pleasurable event of your life which you can cherish now also. Write down three events, three pleasurable moments of your life which you can cherish now also, so that we can have that ray of energy, ray of hope in all of you, so that you can come to know that yes, of course, I have many, many, many more moments. Activity for just a couple of minutes. Somebody is saying audio not clear. Now, is it clear now? Am I audible? Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, all of you. Okay. I'm repeating the task, and the task is, write down three moments of your life which you can cherish now also. Three moments of your life which you can cherish now also. Okay. Going on tours with friends, enjoying family time, being at hometown. Okay. My son calling me Moo. Okay, great. This is not like that. If you don't want to share, please feel free to just write down and keep it with you. If you want to share, the comment box is all yours. Okay, joining job, birth of my daughter, spend time in nature, smiling, dancing, driving. When I'm at natural places with friends, okay, traveling, relaxing. Great. Okay, got 84% in 12th. Wow, great. Become professor. Beautiful. Wonderful. First time giving gift to my mom. Great. Novel when he was in 6th class. Wow, that's really amazing. Incredible. Mm-hmm. All are coming out with beautiful, pleasurable moments. The moments really can be cherished for the entire life. Okay, listening music. Spend time lonely, talk to ourselves. Hill station, mom's food, spending time with my father. Wonderful. Great. So if, okay, adventure in tent, camping, got my first job, my daughter's birth, driving car on slopes, spending time parents and with husband, okay, birth of my son, teaching my students, okay, sister's birth, tour with family, school life. Yes, definitely. School life is that life which we can cherish entire life. And this is something best part of our life. Playing cricket with friends, great. You all are coming out with that child in you. As we all know, there is a child in all of us. Us. And by this, by recalling all these memories, we are making that child coming out. And this is the best part, to feel the high energy, to feel that happiness, to feel the happy hormones in our body. Sitting lonely under open starry sky. Wow, that's really wonderful. School days. See mommy mature. Okay. I don't understand this. Okay. So I think all of you are done with the activity. If somebody is left and want to share the cherishable moments with all of us, you can go ahead. If not, at the end of activity, anyone from your side can give a thumbs up so that we can start or we can continue the session. Childhood days, okay? Because we have one more activity for all of you, so that this is going to be interactive and the activity-based session done. Okay, fine. So I'm getting the message of done here. And this is the quote, simply says, when the going gets tough, the tough gets going. And this is the moral of the resilience. And resilience is something which we can cultivate and which we can have in our life by learning it. And now I'm going to ask few questions from your side. Although we have 20 minutes left, but if you have questions, we'll ask. And one more activity, this I'm going to give you is, and three more things I'm going to share with all of you is, they are, the first thing, positive statements, the affirmations. If you really want to be resilient and if you really want to overcome any stressful situations or the conditions or the events in your life, this is one thing which is going to be very, very, very helpful in your life, and that is positive statement, the affirmations. How many of you know about the affirmations? If you know about the affirmations, give me a thumbs up. What are affirmations and how do they work? Because to be resilient, one has to be good with affirmations. Yes, of course. Most of you know about this affirmations. So yes, this is not going to be done. This is the first thing I was asking you. The second one, what is that positive statement you use for yourself? What is that one statement you use for yourself to make yourself stress-free, to make yourself motivated, to make yourself empowered? That one positive statement from your side, we all want to know from each of your statement so that we all will have that positivity, that energy flowing in each of us, and we will be having the conscious collectiveness. As you all know, whenever we all are thinking in a similar way, in a similar note, we are creating that collective consciousness. So everything will be fine. I can do, I can, I will do. The situation will soon pass away. Very good. Please, all of you, come out with your positive statements so that we all together will create that energy. Be proactive, don't fritter. This shall pass away. I'm capable enough to handle. Very good. I'm blessed. Everything gonna fine. Nothing is impossible. Aage bado. Every situation is perfect. Trust Almighty. All be fine. Truth wins. Okay. Never give up. Dr. Suchishmita is saying we achieve what we conceive. Yes, of course. Set a positive mind. God will guide me. Sanjay K. Sharma is saying, let us participate in God game. Yes, nothing is permanent, not even our struggle. This phase will pass away. I can do it. Yes. Determination, confidence. Subir G. is saying, determination and confidence. Yes. Good time is in the corner. I choose to learn from my mistakes, not be held back by. Wonderful, wonderful statements coming from your side. God is with me. Believe in yourself. Let all be fulfilled. Enjoy every moment. Wonderful. So, if anybody is left, otherwise just give me a thumbs up. We can continue the things. This was about positive statements or the affirmations to create the resilience. The next thing which I'm going to give you as a tip from my side is have mindfulness. Get the mindfulness so that you can be having that presence of mind every time. That focus, that attentiveness, that concentration will not go anywhere. And again, for this mindfulness, I'm going to share a few tips and techniques with all of you. For mindfulness, I'm going to share the grounding exercise with all of you. And mindfulness is, again, a very important technique or tool to cultivate resilience in all of us. So, first of all, just count the sense organs. How many sense organs we all have? Yes, I know the answer. Come on. Yes, yes, yes. So for mindfulness or for the grounding exercise, we are going to use all the five sense organs. You can do this exercise anywhere, anytime. And to improve this mindfulness activity, do it regularly. Make it a part of your life so that your focus, your concentration will increase at par.
So I'm going to share.
Yeah.
Make it a little more clear, mindfulness. Please make it a little bit more clear. What is the mindfulness state?
Yeah, sure. I'll make it more clear. Mindfulness simply says staying in the present moment. If you are doing something, being at that moment, 100%. For example, if we are training a child to be mindful and the child is watching television, as this is a very common thing in these days, child is having the food, television, many things all together. This is not the right way. If the child is watching television, don't give him food. If the child is having food, don't try to involve other things during that time. Similarly, if we are talking about all of us, mindfulness is being in the present moment, 100%. Not thinking about this during that time, not thinking about that during this time. Similarly, if we are juggling between work-life balance, this is something all due to that absence of mindfulness. We are trying to multitask. Previously, it was proven that multitasking is good, but nowadays it has been proven that mindfulness has to be applied in the life so that we all can be more focused and more good at our works. So this is something very brief about mindfulness. And now I'm going to give you the technique which you can involve in your life to improve the mindfulness. So this is a grounding exercise. We all say it as a sensory grounding exercise. What we are going to do here is we are just improving our sense organs' ability. Okay, Dr. Vijay is saying being in the present and experiencing it being non-judgmental. Yes, absolutely. Non-judgmental is the first priority we all should follow. If we are going to be judgmental towards ourselves and towards the people, we are not going to have a happy, healthy life, because this is something which hampers our mindset and mental hygiene, getting disrupted with this judgmental attitude. So if we are going to talk upon the sensory grounding activity, just starting from the first sense organ, that is your eyes. If you are sitting somewhere, if you are standing somewhere, just try to look at one thing, that one thing, only one thing, nothing else. If you are standing outside, just make a target of a tree. If you are sitting in your room, just make a target of something in your room, just be it a lamp, be it something which is anything in your room, like it may be a flower vase, it may be a pen, it may be a diary, it may be a notebook. Just stare at that one thing for at least 2 to 3 minutes constantly. After 2 to 3 minutes, change your focus and then take a pause, take a break, come back to that thing. Do it 5 times. Just 5 times in a day. Do it regularly. And we are going to do this sensory grounding exercise for all the 5 sense organs at a time. Second sense organ is your ears. If you are sitting in a room and if a fan is moving, if something is making noise in your room, not that much noise, we are not going to make it say it a noise, just a voice. Some voice is coming in your environment. Pay attention to that voice. Pay attention to that thing coming from which area, which corner, and at least for 2 to 3 minutes, pay attention to that voice. After taking a pause, just do it again. Do it for 4 times. We do the exercise for eyes for 5 times. For ears, we are going to do it for 4 times. Now, come to the nose, the smell part. Anything in your surroundings, just pick one thing and try to smell it with full focus, full attention, full concentration. Again, the same process will be followed, 2 to 3 minutes, and take a pause and do this thing for 3 times. If you are going to do it for 3 times, definitely the next thing, the next activity is also going to be performed in that given time. The next, we are going to focus on the taste, the fourth sense organ, the taste. So whatever is there in your kitchen, if you want to have a chocolate at that time, if you want to even drink a sip of water, just take a sip of water, feel the taste, enjoy the taste, and just be with that moment of sipping the water. Again, the same process, but the frequency. Like you have to do it for two times. We are doing it in that order, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now, the fifth one, the touch. Use this technique wherever you are sitting. For example, right now you are sitting on a table chair. Just feel the texture of the table. Just be with that moment of feeling. If you will be paying attention to this thing, definitely you are feeling the another way. You have never felt it before. Like, you always sit on that table chair, you always work on that table, but you never touch it, you never felt the texture of it. But now you have to do it and make it a routine of this sensory grounding activity, so that mindfulness can be a part of your life, because mindfulness is of great importance. It is of vital importance in our daily lives to bring well-being in our lives. And one more important thing, whenever you are using all these things in your life, you can change the order of the sense organs. For example, sometimes you can use the touch, the feel 5 times, and the taste 4 times, the smell 3 times, the hearing 2 times, and the watching 1 time. This you can change according to you, so that you are empowering your sense organs in that ascending or descending way adequately. So this is a wonderful sensory grounding technique for improving or empowering the mindfulness. When you will use this, you will definitely see a phenomenal or incredible change in the focus, concentration, and definitely stress is going to be reduced at a certain level. Because we always get stressed because we are not able to continue with many things at a time. It might be stress due to work-life balance. It might be stress due to overworking. It might be stress due to something negative happening in the life. But if you are being present at the moment 100%, definitely you will feel stress-free. Because one thing I would like to add on with this point is, these days we are not suffering from time management issues. We are suffering from energy management issues. We are having the energy management problems, not the time management problems. So please try to channelize the energy in that way that is going to be helpful and productive for you, not destructive for you. So this was the one beautiful activity for all of you, that mindfulness technique. The third point, again activity, or again the technique for all of you, is this is a 4-square breathing, or just a square breathing for all of you. So we talk upon mindfulness, we talk upon affirmations, and now we are talking upon that square breathing technique. These three techniques will definitely reduce your stress up to a level, and then it is going to be cultivating that resilience in you, because somebody who is stress-free can cultivate any kind of quality or coping strategy. Until and unless we are stressed, we cannot, you know, we are stress-free, we cannot... We can do something. So this is a square breathing technique sharing with all of you. Breathe in, counting 4. Breathe out, again counting 4. Take a pause, counting 4. And then again start the square breathing formula. Take a pause for 4. Counting 4 in your mind, taking a pause. Start breathing in, counting 4, holding for 4, again exhaling for 4. So this creates a square, and if you will do it regularly, this is going to work for you as an absolute and amazing technique to make you stress-free, to keep you balanced, to keep you in sync with your thoughts and feelings. So these are the three things from my side, the positive affirmations, the mindfulness sensory grounding technique, and this square breathing technique for all of you. Now, when we are 8 to 10 minutes left with the session, if you have any queries regarding the stress management, regarding how to build resilience or something else regarding your psychological health, please feel free to put your questions in the comment box. I will be happy to answer them. So this is all from my side. Okay, so I'm getting questions from your side. Is expectation good or bad for our mental health? Okay, a wonderful question. Undoubtedly, I must appreciate the question. Expectations are good or bad. Look, expectations are not good or bad. Over expectations may be good or bad. Anything which is over is not at all good for us. If we are expecting at the right amount, at the right time, we are right. Because without this, this is a human tendency to expect certain things, certain emotions from someone. But if we are over expecting, which we are actually doing these days, we are over expecting from ourselves, from the relationships, and from the surroundings, from the environment, from the society. Definitely, this is not going to work. So yes, this is my answer, that expectations are not good or bad. Over expectations are good or bad. Okay, Mr. Sanjay Sharma is asking how this square breathing works. Okay, as we all know, breathing techniques are of great importance to all of us. Just a minute. Okay, this is your question. As we all know, breathing techniques is of great importance to us, and we all should follow this breathing technique ritual. And about the square technique, this is a proven technique by psychologists that if we are using the number 4 and inhaling and exhaling and taking a pause in between the second round of breathing, it really works. It controls all those stress hormones like cortisol and adrenaline in our brain, and it really works on the stress management. So this is something on the square technique question. Okay, Chitra Sen is asking, speak something about memory management. Okay, look, this is something, a broad topic. The memory management is a broad concept to talk upon in a very brief right now. But if you really want to ask just in a nutshell, so I can say memory management is something which you have to work on yourselves. If you can train your brain in your way, you can manage your memory. Yesterday only we celebrated or we observed Alzheimer's Day, which is also called as dementia. And it is observed that dementia, which was actually a disease of geriatrics or elderly citizens of 60 to 65 years, now it has been seen that dementia is seen in the population of just 40-45, which is very, very disheartening and alarming as well. Because these days, when we are actually moving on that track, which gives us stress, and stress itself creates many negative effects on our body parts, on brain as well, and it cuts the neurons. As you know, neurons are the building blocks of our nervous system. So yes, definitely memory management is working on your thoughts and working on your stress management skills. Okay, it is really difficult to bounce back. Any solutions for this? Okay, Miss Rashmita ji, you are absolutely right. Sometimes it is really very difficult to bounce back. Be in that moment for a while is totally okay. But continuously or constantly being in that moment is not at all okay. So please, this is my answer to you. Try to get back from that situation after a while. If that situation is really very difficult, very negative to handle, to deal with, take a pause, be in that situation for a while, and then try to think during that situation, being in that situation, how you will overcome it. And if no thinking abilities were there, no thinking processes were working during that time, don't worry. Don't get panic. Let it be. Change is the only constant thing in this world. Let it be. Let it go. And just, you know, as we all know, this too shall pass. Believe in that mantra. Always believe in yourself. If you are going to deal with this situation, definitely this situation is not going to be for a longer time in your life. So believe in yourself that this too shall pass and I will overcome with this situation in a total new productive transformative way. So believing in yourself is one most important thing for you, Rashmita ji. Okay, so I think questions, if any more questions are there, we can answer them. Fine, I guess no more questions. So now this is over from my side. So I concluded things from my side. If you have anything to ask, please ask. Otherwise, this is over from my side.
Thank you so much, Priyanka Arora, ma'am. It was a really powerful session. Very interactive one. In fact, we have all enjoyed this session a lot. A lot of things to know from your side. We are very much thankful to you for giving us your valuable time and imparting your knowledge, your know-how in this domain amongst us. Thank you, madam.
Thank you.
So this is the end of session number 5 in this FDP. We request all the participants to kindly fill in the attendance form, which is still available in the chat box without fail. And we will next move to session number 6 at 4:15, which will be from Sahaja Yoga. And the speaker is yet to join us. So we will not right now have a 15 minutes break. Maybe you can have a cup of tea and come and join us back at 4:15 p.m. Till then, let's wait for our speaker to join and to begin another new session. Thank you.